A new realm of discovery and wonder. January 1, 2015. It's a joy to open up a page to converse with you again after more than a month. I can't say I've missed you, as I feel we're much more integrated now than when this all began. I've been talking to you each night as I relax to go to sleep. Too bad this doesn't get recorded, as it's been all fascinating information. Aster. Welcome, and more welcome to you. We attend you as always and are always pleased to do so. At this auspicious time, when so many are setting the intention for a new year, what can you share with me about how to go forward in what seems to me to be very new energies? This is not only from my own personal perspective but also is being reported to me by many of my peers. Aster. We would comment on this by confirming that what is being reported and also experienced by yourself, ourselves, is a wholly new realm of discovery and wonder. As you have observed and have been talking about with others for weeks, this is a space of newness and one which is a transitional phase as well. You've noticed this, and for this we commend you. Not only you, but many of you have noticed this, although for many this has been primarily noticed so far as disorientation and frustration perhaps. We commend all who are present in this process, no matter what the nature of their experience. You are the ones in the creation zone, as we mentioned recently as well to one of your associates. You are the ones creating in form. Though we are here in attendance, and from our view we see a broader perspective, you are the mighty ones which are the specialists in creating in form, and in riding the waves of physical manifestation. We wonder continually at the ways you manage to do this and at your immense capacities. Yet, there are currently so few of you that embrace this truth as your own. The time for the energies present in this realm of creation that you inhabit to support such unconsciousness is fading fast. All of you are going to be amazed at how quickly those notions of being powerless and of being at the whim of the universe instead of being the creator of form yourselves is going to dissolve and fade away. If this is so, then it's the most wonderful news imaginable. I guess my question would be if we are ready to embrace such responsibilities at this stage of our development. Aster. We laugh with you, O Creative One. Those of you in form at this time, or at least the greater part of your collective on planet at this time, are here in service to this moment. None are here by accident, nor has there ever been any such a thing. The universe doesn't create anything at all, anywhere, ever, that hasn't a purpose, so why would we think that this would be so, here and now? Beyond purpose, is the fact that all are, in divine timing, playing out what they came to do. For some, this is a very conscious journey, and for others it's not, but all are placed where they are, at all times, wherever it is that their soul has determined is the best placement in order for them to be who they are. There's nothing more to this, and it isn't the complexity that the human mind in its current state of development will attempt to make of it. It's so much simpler, and like all truth, it simplifies, and allows for greater and greater mysteries to reveal themselves, like dominoes falling in a line, one after the other, or like a cog that snaps into its place and allows all the gears to move in synchronicity. What we're saying is that each of you is placed in the perfect place to be who you are, and this bears repeating. Your individual capacities are such that you only need to embrace who you are, and be that, in order for the energies that are now the prevailing ones in the realm of form you inhabit to support you. The challenge at this time, which you have certainly been witnessing for yourself, if one of raising the bar for all the foundational principles of this realm you live in. Hence the frustration and the disorientation being experienced by nearly everyone you talk to. As all beings are moving out of living unconsciously and into bringing awareness to that which used to be unconscious, many foundational notions of what works and why are going to come into view, many of these for the first time in a very long time. Moving forward into the creation of Nova Earth, and out of the sleepwalking phase of the past, is going to demand this from everyone, as what used to be taken for granted as how things work is going to be served up to all who are, with intent for the good of all, getting busy with the work of recreating all the systems planet-wide that aren't in alignment with this principle. For the good of all is a pretty lofty order, that's for sure. Certainly, in my lifespan, most of what I've seen isn't like this and isn't like this from its very roots, or foundations, as you say. Are we up for this tall of an order, I wonder? It's been such a long haul, and I'm not even going to pretend I'm not weary. Aster. Take heart, lover of Gaia, and lover of life itself. This is the time you came for, and you're holding within you all you will need to triumph. The same is so of all who care to be who they are, and bring their inherent goodness and their mighty intent for the good of all to all they do. No more can be asked from any being in any realm, and no more is ever needed. The true nature of this universe is one that is woven through and through with love, as this is the fabric of all that is. It's the primal and primary nature of all forms that exist, or they wouldn't have the life force to sustain form. Notice how simple this is, and how the truth of this simplifies. We would ask you to consider the very foundational principles which have held this realm in unconsciousness for so very long. Those notions that hold that love is a weak force, and that to be love is a vulnerability one can't afford in order to survive, are perfect examples of foundational principles that take on a ridiculous complexity in order to exist at all. They're obvious lies which has no basis in reality, and never have, even into eternity. All the evidence of everything that exists is there for anyone to see in every moment which disproves these illusions. Everywhere is life force, and this is the same force as love. Everything that lives is comprised of this same energy. It's bursting with life and it's prolific in its abundance. All of nature and all kingdoms of Gaia, the very nature of Gaia herself, display this life force and love in their very existence constantly. In order for one not to notice this simplicity, it's taken a massive amount of effort over millennia to complicate and veil these truths. The current energies are wiping these complexities and illusions away at this time. Believe in yourself. Rejoice. You are the lucky ones, the masters of time and space. The specialists in the divine zone of physical creation come to be who you are. You are the divine mixture of heaven and earth come to be here now. This all makes perfect sense to me, as you know, but I wonder how many will embrace this and allow the current energies to support them through all this chaotic stuff that seems to be happening just everywhere. It's so prevalent that it's difficult to focus on the obvious and simplifying truths you're sharing here. Aster. We're not suggesting that one should ignore the breakdown of the old, as watching this unfold is a part of the process too. You are also here to bear witness to how what isn't true and what isn't built on a proper foundation cannot endure. This is the divine time for this to be made manifest, and you are the agents of divinity in form. We're suggesting that the greater part of one's focus would be more properly and efficiently useful if placed on utilizing this chaotic energy that is now freeing itself from old forms to intelligently, from your mighty hearts, and with the intent for the good of all, to build new forms to serve you. Well, that makes perfect sense as well. It seems like we're so used to having every bit of our energy siphoned off to serve those with the intent to feed on us collectively. It's a hard thing to let this idea settle in. The thought that the energies will now support those who care about the good of all is one that may take some time to really take hold. Aster. And yet we assure you this is so. And we assure you that all energy is just that. As duality dissolves as a paradigm driving all creation in your realm, and integration and unity becomes the principles that guide the new era, there will be less and less hesitation to take these energies in whatever form they have been in, and to use them to build new forms which will support humanity and will support Gaia and all her life forms and kingdoms. You are the masters of transmutation, and as such, all energies are existing for you to utilize. It is up to you, both individually and collectively, to do so using the inherent divinity within you. The intelligence, the power, the intent, the love, is within you. The abilities you need exist within you and need not be learned, nor is there the need for them to be given. You are all this and more. Remember, O lovers. Remember. Further than this remembering, is understanding that though you remember beyond the long reign of unconsciousness which is now ending, you're now in a completely new space energetically. This is territory none of us have traversed before. Take heart. The best of the best are present to find the ways forward. You are these specialists. Honor yourselves and give each other this same honoring too. The universe creates with the most divine intelligence. Nothing exists which is placed incorrectly or without the attributes needed to be all that is needed to live and to live abundantly. All the experiences you've had along the way have been those chosen to bring you now to the most exquisite and miraculous version of who you are and to help you be who you are in this very moment. We attend you all, and we watch this holy moment unfold in wonder. We leave you now with many blessings to all for the changing of your year. It promises to be a year like no other has ever been. Congratulations in advance for your mighty creations. Farewell, Aster, and all who attend me here. Many blessings to you as well. Channeled by Andrea Scully. AndreaStarOO.com